Now, in this video, we will investigate the use of the command line tool, tcpdump, for packet analysis. Many Linux systems comes pre-installed with the tcpdump utility. Although it doesn't have a GUI like Wireshark, it is still capable of doing a decent job in packet analysis. We're going to use our Kali Linux machine, our Kali Linux VM, so let's fire up our VMware workstation. We're going to start our Kali Linux VM. Right, and if you have not changed the password, the default password will be Kali and Kali. Right, the default username is Kali and the password is Kali, I mean. So let's wait for it to get started. Okay, there you go. Okay, so the default the username created is Kali and the password is Kali. Okay, after you log in, what you need to do is to open up a terminal window. Right, when you have a terminal window here, you can use the tcpdump command. Tcpdump. Right, so again, in Linux, if you want to know how to use a command, you can check the man page, tcpdump, right? So as you can see, it's a command that can help you to dump traffic on the network. Have a read through the description. You need to be root to run this command, right? So as usual, if you want to quit the man page at any point in time, type Q, right? So as you can see, I'm not a root user, right? I'm just a Kali. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sudo root sudo bash, right? So I am going to put in the password Kali, right? And now you see the prompt changes to a hex, right? So this means that I'm now root, right? I am now a root user. Okay, so to run tcpdump, and if you do not know how to use it, there is a tcpdump dash dash help, right? So this is all the arguments that you can use for tcpdump. Now, for the purpose of our demonstration, we shall open another window, right? So you can open another window and put them side by side, right? Let's put them side by side. So I have two windows here, right? And one window that is a root, and one window as a normal user, right? And I'm going to use the tcpdump to listen onto a particular interface. Okay, so for the purpose of our demo, we'll use the loopback interface. Okay, so to see the different network interface that this machine has, you can issue the command IP address. Show, right? So I have Ethernet 0, okay, and the loopback. So for the demo of tcpdump, you're going to use the loopback interface, right? So what we're going to do is we are going to issue the command again. Let's look at the command option, tcpdump dash dash help. Right, so tcpdump dash I interface. So I can listen to, I can listen for traffic on a particular interface. Right, so in this case, I'm going to listen to the traffic on loopback interface. Right, so the command that I'm going to issue is tcpdump dash I, specifying the interface, LO. Okay, so I'm listening on loopback 0. Okay. So again, if I check the IP address, you can see that loopback 0, okay, basically has the IP address of 127.0.0.1, right? So to reach the loopback interface, I can issue a ping, right? I can issue ICMP ping to 127.0.0.1, right? And as you can see, when I'm issuing the ping, the packets will be captured on the other screen where TCP dump is running. Right, so the ping in Linux is unlike the ping in Windows. You actually have to break out of it by issuing Control C. Right, but if you look at the TCP dump capture, you can see that you know, localhost is sending to localhost. The protocol is ICMP. Alright, and echo request, that's the ping that is coming in. And once I receive, the localhost receives the request, it's going to issue the reply, right, back to itself in this case. Right, so this is an example of how you can use a TCP dump to capture traffic. Now, let's go back to the TCP dump command again. Right, TCP dump dash dash help, and you can see of all the options that is available. Right, well, actually it doesn't show here. 1, 2, 3 is for under. Right, let's do a man TCP dump then. Actually, it falls under here. Right, one of the options is dash x that I want to share with you. Right, so let's go to man TCP dump for more detailed explanation of all the different options. Right, so I want to share with you the dash x option. Right, let's search for dash x. So you put a slash and dash x. Okay, so the dash x option, lowercase x, what does it mean? When passing and printing, in addition to printing the headers of each packet, print the data. So it's going to print everything of the packet, right, in hexadecimal form. Right, so in hex form. So let's try it out. So what I want you to try issuing is the command tcp dump dash ILO. You're still going to listen to the loopback interface, and but this time I want you to add the dash x option behind, right? Okay, then for the other window, right, for the other window, as usual, I want you to issue the ping, right, ping 127.0.0.1, and observe the output this time around. So as you can see, the output that you see on the captured outputs actually consists of a lot more data. It's actually the whole packet, right? I'm gonna stop it. Right, so all these are in hexadecimal forms that you see. Okay, so hexadecimal. Right, so this is just the counter, but this is the hexadecimal form of the packet that is received. Okay, so I'm going to stop the packet capture here. Now, I'm also going to show you another option which is particularly helpful. So, man TCP dump again. Alright, and there is this thing called the expression, right? So, one of the things that we can look out for is host. Right, so... Yeah, so... If you look at the example, to print all the packets arriving at or departing from sundown. Sundown is basically just a machine name, right? A host name. Right, so you can TCP dump followed by host sundown. So basically it will only filter the packets that is sent from sundown or coming to some sundown. Right, that has the source address or the destination IP address from sundown. Right, so and again you can form complicated expressions, right, similar to the filters in Wireshark, right? Let's give it a try. Right, so let's do a TCP dump dash I LO. Okay, we will dump on the loopback interface, we will dump out the full packet, and let's say we're going to do host 127.0.0.2 this time, right, instead of 127.0.0.1. So if you go back to the other window and you issue ping 127.0.0.1, observe the output. Right. You can see that although the packets are sent to the loopback interface and sent back, the echo replies get sent back, but nothing gets captured on the TCP dump. This is because we are specifically looking out for 127.0.0.2. Right, the host 127.0.0.2, okay, and which doesn't match the sending host. Now, the one thing that I want to point out is that with the packets, right, that is the full packet that is captured here, right, we can actually decode this IP packet, right? We can actually tell from this output here. Things like whether it's IP version 4 or IP version 6, right? So there are actually ways, because this is actually representing the whole packet, we can identify the source, destination, IP address, and so on from this output here.